nonsense, gola, a foolish man who came and was talking foolish, useless man. Please send me the number of gola relative. I want to call and ask them if their father, uncle, brother is correct. If he has some sense. If actually he did that PhD. You see, some of my people, don't be sad. When it's those, I've given you three instances. They have not lost control on Amazonia. But rest assured that as the national shutdown, the Amazonia national shutdown, the ANS, as it picks team today, it will continue picks team going ahead and let's be focused. And please, all those who want to move for medical issues, please, we hope that before now you have taken adequate medical directives. Please, medical people, Amber Boys can help you to move if you are sick. But it's very dangerous because, like we said, when we see any car coming during the shutdown, we assume that those are people moving with campaign materials. We assume that these are people going to campaign. And we assume that we act almost immediately. We act on you. We act on you. We don't spare. So please, that issue. Now this takes me now to the next issue about Atenyamponji. Atenyamponji has run his mouth claiming on Media and insinuating that some other boys have dropped their weapons. My people, do I not fight lie? The fight lie. No, I'm a boy, never drop in weapons. I think about GD do a psychological challenge. He wants to travel you. He wants to travel you. Those few other boys that say, come and drop your weapons, they'll give you lie to lie. I think about GD lied. No, I'm a Pekin, never drop in weapons. And when he tell them, say, I'm a boys, when I'm ADF, ASC force, or Nasuka death, whatever, none of them will drop down their weapons. Those weapons will continue to multiply. They will keep it until such a time that we shall sit on the table as equals and negotiate and talk as man, as men and women. And we must continue to do that. So please, make not see that nonsense post. And not say the next thing I say. They will take military people. They will take even Anglophone people. Eh? Military. Or they will go to Buddha. Take some guys them. They will dress them in like Amber Boys. Make they come from Media talk say, eh? We are Amber Boys. We're sorry. We're tricked to join this thing. We blame NDF. We blame Sarko. We blame Mark Barrettam. We blame Tapang. We blame Ayaba. We blame Eric. These are people that have told us to pick up weapons. We are sorry. They deceive us. They lied to us. We're not Chinese. We are now, for one, an indivisible Cameroon. Fake. Those are all major tactics. Because I show that now they are desperate. When someone is desperate, listen, Atenyamponji is preparing your mind. He has told us, he don't tell we say, I'm a boy, they don't start to drop their weapons, they don't surrender. Now, two, he don't tell you. You never see any photo. You never see anything. He don't call, he don't talk so for media. They don't write them. So they prepare your mind, he prepare you. So that by the time, he don't bring few boys away, don't stage them. When you see them, you gonna say, mama mia, I don't die. In fact, this struggle, I don't go me. I don't go me. This one way, I'm a boy, the house that's on the bus, I don't go me. You will leave. Then the few other boys who saw it, maybe those ones who have very weak mind, say, hey, me too, I won't go. So it's a whole political game. Now, whole tactic for make sure society, for make sure say, maybe we, for defeat we. So then they fight with all angles. And they fight with financially, and they fight with psychologically, and they fight with militarily. But so far as God don't give we the strength for being on this media, we go expose their tactics one after the other. So I did tell you, don't say in future, that's what they will do. They will take boys them when they talk pigeons like us. They will bribe them, they will put them for media. They'll give them script, say talk now so. When they talk so, blame Ayaba. Blame Sako, blame Chris Anu, blame Tapang, blame Magbareta, blame Akosong. They will call most names for with them. So when they talk, they say, no, now Magbareta be make a go pick weapons. Now so we don't disown them. Eh? When you see now, what will happen now? We now and the front, we now son the government now. We have a son now. We now with Ajo. Yeah? With Ajo. Hey! You see? I said it. You see, diaspora, you are the cause. You see, diaspora, you are the cause. Look at that, you are the cause. What do we do? We keep arguing, hitting our heads. Lagopina is happy, happy. Please, I didn't tell you that game. That's the first point of attack and punching. Either you talk, say, I'm a person, the next thing I say, they go stage jam. When they stage jam, they go blame the diaspora. And when they blame the diaspora, now, on measure now, it will be 1 week argument. Diaspora with big book. It will be 1 week of audios. You will hear audios from Germany to UK to USA, Canada. Audios come out. Insult. Someone will give audio for full insult. Insult. They're going to insult you left and right. They're going to insult you left and right. But I don't talk say, rest assured say, now game that way it day. And make we as a people, make we not fall for that game. May we not fall for that game. I swear, I don't care to happen. Now, I don't defam. When it happens, when you see them, don't fall for it. Keep on the price. And why way, if you don't hear today, so don't make some audio where don't go around. That audio, it don't reveal some person where he be pretend for talk with them about fake profile. When you hear that audio, you say, listen, like you probably not say our strength lies on the media. That is why they go take firm, lobby firm, for fight us also majorly. They not say for ground zero, we have won them. They know. Let me tell you the truth. La République knows that on ground zero, we have won them. They know. So now, they know the role of the media. They know that what happens on social media translates on ground zero. Within the past week, you've seen the audios coming out. Oh no, so it translates on ground zero and it has some effect on ground zero. They know. So what that is that they want to now attack our strongest point, which is media. So what they'll do is that they will bring in fake profiles. They will go to Eric's platform. They will come to my platform. They'll go to Ivo's. They'll go to Capo's. Everywhere on media. Their job is to make sure that when you talk good about IG, they kick against. That's what the audio is saying. The audio was trying to say things that this people do. When you talk anything good about AGC, they kick against. When you talk anything good about Sukadev, they kick against. In fact, their role is to do the opposite of what you are saying. So that when you come, you see now people are arguing left and right, and you become confused. That is what the audio did. Now, let me tell you what I did yesterday. And Eric Tatoa has been saying this. This is the thing. When you see any, listen, a bona fide Amazonian, a true, genuine Amazonian, no matter the anger we get them against diaspora, no matter the anger we get them against any leader, will not at any point in time insinuate that let the struggle, let's end and let go to the Olympic. No one. No one will at any point in time insinuate. I said, Jame, no anything. But when you see their comments, let me tell you a tactic. Yesterday, I blocked about 50 of them. 50. And I said, when I click on the profile, you go there, my brother, you will not see any one Amazon post. Now, let me tell you, there are two types of fake profiles. The first type of fake profile, I don't call it fake. I call it Sodo profile. These are Amazonians who are in the diaspora, including the Republic, and also on ground zero, who support the revolution, but maybe by their job, by what they do, by maybe family ties or so, they do not want to expose their real names. These ones, I agree with them. Because not be any man will show a face. Me, I don't show my face. You know me say, any man will show a face. These people, they support in their own different ways, respectively. This type of profiles, they give their own funny names. These are genuine Amazonians who are also on ground zero, but because they know that if they have their real names, they might be monitored by the Republic. These are people who have pseudo names. I call them pseudonyms, not fake. They're not fake. They're real pseudonyms. And what they do is that when you go on their profile, what do you see? You will see that they have been sharing our posts. Alepop, you will see my life shows. You will see even their own personal posts, making for the revolution, giving their own opinions. If they are angry with any leader, they will say it. You will see posts shared from them, from Ivor, from myself, from Eric Tator, from Yannick, from Prince Jekka. You will see them sharing all posts. You can see a history. Those ones are genuine. Those ones you don't block. They are genuine. These are pseudo. They are there. And when you see their comments, you know that these people, even when they disagree, they mean good for the revolution. The next type, these are fake people. People who are francophones and people who are also Amazonians, that they want this nonsense of one individual Cameroon. What they do? They take names of Amazonians. Eh? Somebody from La République. But they will create a profile and call himself Agbo John. So that when you see that name Agbo John, you think that, hey, this Agbo John is Mamanu and he's talking against Siku. You hear? So it goes with psychology. They take names from Lebia Lem, from Tufako to this. That resembles the name from my areas. And when they come, they do those foolish comments. And when you see, you say, hey, now how do you know this was a fake? Click on their profile, go there. My papa, you don't want to see any post shared by them. What do you see? You see puppy, dogs, they're scammers. You see puppies and dogs. You see things running there. That's what do you see? You don't want to see one post shared by them. These ones are fake. And these are the ones that La République has recruited. They call them the army, social media army. They come there, they monitor. They come when you say A, they say B. Their role is to jambox us. And their role is that, and they are also in WhatsApp groups. They make audios. They speak good English. They speak good pidgin. They make audios in female and male voices. They cry. When they make the audios go viral. And so often, we as Amazonians, because we are too emotional, we hear an audio, we see a post on WhatsApp without any name that you know. You don't even investigate. You jump on it and you start crucifying. That is their role. Their role is to cause, to jambox us, that we keep arguing, then we forgot on the price. We forgot on the price, then La République now strategize, we organize election, they will be voting, and when they will be voting, they will not come and say, the diaspora had failed you. Despite what, there was elections. Despite what, there was voting. Despite what, there was election. Now, can you now come back and believe in your one individual Cameroon? Can you now see that the diaspora for this number of years have deceived you? Beware of this people. They are in your WhatsApp groups. They are there. Their role is to inflame. Their role is not to deflame. Every time they say something, they inflame it. They inflame it and take it to different proportions. Their role is to sabotage. Their role is to do things against revolution. Beware of this set of persons. People that you don't know. People that have never stood for the revolution. Beware of them. Beware. They are in WhatsApp groups. They join with funny names. They will put their names there. Agbo Joseph, Ndzi Charles, Peter, this. Esuke, Leonga, this. Nalova, this. They put it there. And they come and they comment. So yesterday, I blocked about 50. And for each of them that I blocked, I went to their profile. Hey, I saw it. How can you are on your profile and you claim you are Amazonian? You have put on the profile picture. They put Amazonian flag there. Put it like when you see Amazonian flag, you say, oh no, maybe this one is Amber. It's Jenny Amber. When you see his comments, you go there, you like. You say yes, oh yes, yes, you like. Click on their profile. I've given you the assignment. Do it now. Do it now. Go and click. When you click, look at their post. You will not see. You don't see post shared by me. You don't see that by Tato. You don't see that by Akoso. You will not see. You will see puppies, birds, and dogs. Also, some funny white man, white girl, they don't put up there. You see. Then you see one or two mutual friends. Or maybe one. Or you see no mutual friends. No mutual friends. Those are people who have been designed to sabotage us. Beware of them. I've told you there are two types. There are genuine ones, those who use pseudonyms, that we know them. We know them. They are out there because of one of the issues that do not be known. When you see their comments, you know these are people who are just worried. But there are those who come there, they come out and say rubbish to divide us. They insult, they call, they jump us on our heads. Please beware. Social media is good for us, but social media can bring us down. It can slow, it can delay our revolution. So that is the point I want to talk about. Now I'm going to move to the Ekema saga and Batibo, and I will end the show with the Batibo issue. Fellow Amazonians, I know that this is the moment you have been waiting. I am aware that you are speaking English, because I'll flow well when I speak English. Fellow Amazonians, I know that this is the moment you have been waiting. I know I have read you, I have heard you. You have been worried and been asking questions that why is Mark Barretta, your humble servant, the messenger of the People's Platform, not talking about issues happening in Batibo? Or maybe not coming out here running, condemning in a very hard way and saying all this. I read you, I hear you, and I know that some of you have been disappointed. You have been disappointed for genuine reasons. You have been disappointed because you believe in Mark Barretta. You believe in this platform. You have been disappointed because you know that when things happen like this, Mark Barretta will be the first to come out and talk. And for all those who are disappointed, for all those who are disappointed, their disappointments are genuine. I will not stand out here to start defending myself to say this or that. But again, I wish to inform you the psychology of my thought before I move into the Batibo issue. The psychology of my thought, the way I believe, I want to give you a history. I want to give you a small history that maybe you have been following this platform and you have not studied me from time immemorial. If we all agree, you agree with me, you agree with me that since from the time I was the consortium interim leader, I have always held the position where I don't come out against leaders or fellow activists in ways that others will do. You agree with me that I will always come out with statements, giving position statements, and sometimes I will differ with you, 100% differ. I will go in a different direction with you. That was the same with ACK. When I endorsed ACK, and most of you were totally in dichotomy. It is because I believe in my own personal thought. I believe in my own ways of reasoning and thinking. I do not believe that the way to call a leader out is to vilify, is to sabotage, is to bring down that person. Because when the reverse is done upon me, I will be angry. And I want you to bear with me that I have held all leaders on the same pedestal. There is no leader in the revolution that I have come out more than the others. It was not Bala. It was not Sako. It was not Ziko. It was not Tassan. All of them. I want to give you this history. When you want to be disappointed, want to be angry, you must go back and say, but Mark Barretta from the time immemorial had always called out these leaders in different ways. Even with Milan Atam, the only moment I came out very hard against Milan Atam was the time that he wrote against me and said something, and I also responded very hard. The right time I came out very hard against Milan Atam. Of course, I disagreed with them with the formation of Scoop, and I still do. I disagree with them with positions, and that is how I have done. I have called Batasang out in my live show, but I have done it with the same way I have done to every leader. I have disagreed with Julius Ayoktabe, but I have done that in the same way I have done with every leader. And I have disagreed with Chris Anu, with Sako, and I have done the same way I have done with any other leader. And so I know deep within me, if you look back, it is not as if I have held one leader to different standards and I have allowed another leader. I have held all of them in the same way. And I've come out in ways to condemn issues. To condemn issues, not persons. I have condemned issues, not persons. Because I do not believe to dignify, to vilify people. I still believe that every leader in this revolution, they still have the role to play, despite their issues, despite the differences. So fellow Amazonians, those on this platform, you will have to bear with me that I will not have to change. It is me. It's my being. Had it been I was very hard against one leader and leave another, then I will succumb. And so I find it very difficult just because I want to please those who are very disappointed in me. I find it very difficult just because I want to please to come out. If I do that, I won't sleep very well. So whatever I say, whatever I do, I want it to come from what I believe. And you should judge me from what I say, from what I do. Because no person, no activist is more than the people. No activist is more than Amazonia. And I'm not more than Amazonia. And I'm also liable to criticisms and so. So I don't want to give you this backgrounds that you know where I'm coming from, and you know my philosophy. My philosophy is that I focus more on the issues. I do not listen naturally to one side of audios and take a position. I do not. Because I have come to understand that when you listen to one side of all audios and you take a position, you could be biased. Yes, I'm also very disappointed in actions going on in Batibo. And I'm ashamed because this is not what we opted for. It gives the international community a home. Now let me warn Amazonians that we ourselves will be the one to delay our revolution to many years if we keep on doing what we are doing. We will be the one to delay ourselves many years because in the community, they will fund us. Those who are sympathetic, they will fund us. They will stand by us to see us that instead for us to come together and fight our enemy, we are trying to fight ourselves. So on a general note, no leader, no activist, no camp, no amber, no person should attack another camp. I have said this, and I said it in my statement last week or last 2 weeks when I addressed the Bessie issue. When I addressed the Bessie issue, I gave to you what the ADF said, and I told you what the ADF said. I said it clearly. I told you what I got from the other side of what they say. And I made it to understand that sometimes it becomes very difficult. For example, the ADF claimed that one of the reasons why they went to dismantle the Bessie camp was because one of the soldiers was buried alive. But those of us said, no, that was a lie. That was a lie. And so sometimes it becomes very difficult to separate who is telling the truth, who is telling lies, who is telling lies. So I said last time, and I'll maintain it, that the ADF has a tendency of what we call dominance. And I did condemn that. I have told them, I have spoken to some of their leaders, and I have told them that they have this tendency of dominance, to think that they are the dominating force. And I have said it will not happen. No force on ground zero is a dominant force, because a camp with one or two persons is also important than a camp with 50, 30, or 100 fighters, because each of them helps each other. And I still stand by that. I said the ADA and the agency, they have this history, they have this mentality of dominance, and that is what is disturbing them, dominance. And I have condemned it, and I have done so fiercely in my statement last time. I did that for those who never read. And the issue now, the present issue, that where we are hearing about, that the ADF went to the main camp in Batibo to attack, and the fighters were arrested. My able brother Sikot was live on Facebook, and he said a lot of things about that. I have spoken with Sikot one-on-one, and he will tell you that I always share with him, I always tell him what the other side is telling me. Comrade Ayaba came out yesterday and gave an audio and said instead the other side came to attack their camp, and they have arrested their soldiers. Why the ADF is saying their soldiers were arrested by the other side, the other side is saying the ADF came to attack and they are arrested. Who is telling the truth? Who is telling lies? But we can infer from prevents. When an organization becomes under attack over and over, there is an issue. And so it is the place of the ADF and agency and the Troyeba to re-examine what is happening. Because we have this complaint always, every time, ADF. That means something must be going on. And that something is what I have defined as dominance. What I've defined as dominance. We've heard Comrade Akwanga, who came out the last time and complained about the ADF in Mato. But thank God that it was resolved peacefully, and we saw the ADF and Sukadef in a video in Mato. They made a video, they were talking, smiling, and so those misunderstandings are bound to happen. We have seen that. And for those who have the impression that the ADF acted in Moyoka with Godfather and his children, they are wrong. The issue in Moyoka had nothing to do with the ADF and Dr. Troyeba or General Ivo. It has nothing. All those forces there, they are under the ASC. It has nothing. My friend Eric Tato has said this. So, when we come back now to Batibo, this is what and before coming live, finally I got the number of General Ivo. I have been to General Ivo the first time I wrote to him. The first time I wrote to him on WhatsApp. I've wrote to him and I said, General Ivo, what is, in fact, I breached protocol. Because I've spoken with ADF people, I've listened to Dr. Charles Ayaba's audio, and it's different from what Sikot is saying. So I reached out to General Ivo. I said, General Ivo, I am Mark Barretta. What is happening in Batibo? This was my statement to him. What is happening in Batibo? I, Mark Barretta, I am open. I am, thank God, I speak with both sides, because both sides are open to me. I can reach out to Sako, I can reach out to Ayaba, I can reach out to Sikot, I can reach out to anyone in any of the groups because of the way I prosecute the revolution. So I said, I am in a better place to broker peace. Please, can you use me so that we can make peace in Batibo, whatever is happening? Before coming live, I have not had any response from General Ivo. So, fellow Amazonians, something is happening in Batibo, but I think the leaders concerned, and here I want to hold Dr. Choyaba in a very high esteem. Dr. Choyaba, as a leader of the ADC and the CIC of ADF, you have the responsibility to ensure that the issue in Batibo is settled. It comes to, you have the responsibility to ensure. And I want to say this unequivocally, that whatever happens in Batibo, if Amazonians for once, if there's any Amazonian, if any fighter amongst themselves pull a bullet amongst themselves, this struggle, now hear me out. If any day, any time, any fighter on ground zero hold their guns against each other, this struggle comes to an end. It comes to an end because it will be a big disgrace. It will be a big slap on the on how far we've come. How far we've come. And it will take away. And that's why you see, most often I'm so bitter. I find it very difficult to come out here and say these things, because you see, the world ruled on perception. Sometimes you might be a very good man, but the people have a very wrong perception about you, and you lost life. So it is politics, it's about perception. You might be a very good person, but once the world has a very negative perception against you, you perish. So let us not give the international community, let us not give those who are sympathetic to us, that if they support us, we shall turn our guns against ourselves. I am calling on Dr. Joe Ayaba, the leader of the ADF, that you have, as someone that you have been in the revolution for this number of years, and rightfully so, that we respect, that you have a duty, whether you are wrong or right. We have to keep aside egos. Whether you are wrong or right, you have the responsibility to ensure that the issue in Batibo comes to an end immediately, and it's been settled. Because it has derailed our focus. It has slowed fundings. It has made Bond Ground Zero to be bittered. I'm talking about Dr. Choyaba here because he's the leader of the, I want to forget about those of the other camp. I'm talking about him because he is the face of the ADF. He has been in the revolution for years. And me, my brother, I do respect him a lot. I have to say, some people go around and try to insinuate that the ADF or Choyaba is like people. That is an insult. Yes, I want to tell other worship that I, Mark Barretta, I still have 100% support and confidence to Dr. Joe Ayaba. I still have 100% support and confidence to the ADF. I do. Likewise, like I do to all the other groups and to the interim government. And I'm calling on Dr. Joe Ayaba that the noise coming from ground zero, from Odios, he has the means and the powers to put it to end. It must not be, responded with another audio, with fears, with hard tones, and so it must not. Dr. Choyaba, please. This is your brother Mark Barretta. You know that we have argued many times on WhatsApp. Some people say that I am ADF. Your members in the ADF have accused me that I'm the one giving legitimacy to the IG. I've been accused from left and right about this. But my only interest is to see Amazonia first. And my only interest is to see that our boys on ground zero have been catered for. That is why I'm here. And I'm coming. I don't want to know who is wrong or right in Batibo. Guns must not exchange. If guns exchange, then be ready to have 90% of Amazonians pull it out of the revolution. And when they pull out, they will expect all of you in the diaspora to go down there and fight. We cannot be crying that we need bullets, and we expect bullets to fly across the air against our own self. For what reason? For what? There is no reason on earth, no reason at all. I don't want to care about the other camp, what they say or what they do. I'm talking to my elder brother who was dismissed from the University of Boya for standing for University of Boya reforms. I'm talking to my elder brother who left, who has put his life on the line for many years. I'm talking to my elder brother who now has joined the generation to ensure that we are free. And even if you are right in Batibo, or you are wrong, no matter what the position, I want Dr. Choyeba to end this. To end this. In my Bessy statement last week, I said, fighters, no matter who is keeping them, should be released. We need fighters on the road to do national shutdown. We need fighters to fight the Republic. We don't need fighters in jungles, in caves, being chained. It is bad fit. It's bad fit. It's bad fit. It's bad fit. I don't have any moral authority. I don't have any means. I don't have any evidences. I don't have any ways to say this. Actually, what happens? I'm going to be sincere with you. I've heard from Dr. Cho Ayaba. I've heard from the other side. Both have given different accounts. I cannot come here and condemn and judge and say this is the best. I can hold Dr. Cho Ayaba to a high account to say whether you are wrong or right and whatever is happening in Batibo. And going forward, let there be peace. Let there be peace between all the various groups. I know very well the impression that Ground Zero fighters have for General Ivo. I know very well that in FACO, when you speak to most of the fighters, you hear them. Their impression about General Ivo is very good. I know because I speak with a lot of them. I know that General Ivo has been most of the one that through his means he offers G-nuts to those in FACO. I know that. I have been doing that to some in the Northern Zone, in Meme. I know that those in Meme, FACO, when you talk to them, fighters, you get they have a very good parole. And I want to beg those in the diaspora, please, let us not use our hatred for any leader to confuse actors on Ground Zero. I am begging in the name of God. Let us allow actors on Ground Zero to these our forces to continue doing what they are doing. They are not fighting as ADF or SOCADEF or ASC. They are fighting as Amber Boys. They are fighting as people who have given their life to see Ambassador free. Dr. Choyeba, please, I beckon upon you that don't allow guns to fly in air in Batibo. Bring down the tempers. You have the means. You have it. For the love that you have for Ambazonia, if you allow that to happen, then indirectly you would have contributed to destroy the very revolution you have fought for many years. And history will not have some of us in the good books. History will not forgive some of us. I pray that going after this, things will happen. And from the other side, whatever happens, please, pipe down. Pipe down. I hate to come live and be talking about issues because I'm supposed to be talking about Popobia. But I feel, I'm ashamed. Let me tell you, I'm ashamed. I feel very disgruntled. I feel as if I've been given a big slap. That I'm out here, easy for me to be talking about against Popobia. I'm talking publicly about groups against each other. I'm not supposed to do that. I'm not supposed. That's not the revolution I